Finance, we've got our financial expert Tebo Homafodi in studio.
In studio.
How you doing?
I'm good, and you, Uncle Teb?
I'm very well. Okay, so it's our first proper financial segment of the year. Now, we're going to talk investment options to get your money working for you. We know that many people have grown up having conflicted values around money and wealth, okay, and the misunderstanding of how the two actually work together. What are the different ways? Let's start there. What are the different ways that you can invest money, Tebo?
Okay, we're fortunate enough that in South Africa, we've got a lot of options on how you can invest your money. I mean, we've got things like unit trust. We've got things like money market. We've got the tax free account. And we've got things like the investment clubs that are actually out there. And I mean, being some of them stock found as well.
Can you just explain these investment clubs? I've wondered for the longest time about these investment clubs. Take me through it.
Okay, I'll make an example. I've got an investment club where it's me and my friends with like-minded individuals that our main aim is to acquire profitable income-generating assets. So we are strategic in such a way that we would decide to say on a month-to-month base, you know, this is how much we bring in together, or on an annual base, whether being from a personal capacity point of view or is it from a business point of view. So with us, we've gone to an extent of registering an entity, a trading entity. So it's in this entity that we invest in or we buy assets in.
A lot of people say that, look, I can't invest, I can't save money because my paycheck doesn't allow me to do so. It's actually so interesting that South Africans are generally not good savers in comparison to other countries. The JSE came out and said it believes that the only way to address this concern is by people reading up and actually saving and starting that saving culture from a very young age. Now, let's talk about investment. Does your paycheck actually have anything to do with whether you can invest or save or not?
No, definitely. Your paycheck does. Remember,
I was hoping he was going to say no.
Me too.
No. It does. And I'll answer this in two ways. It shouldn't, but it does. And reality is that there's certain organizations or companies that would allow you to invest on. Their objective is that they're looking at high net worth individuals. Or they're looking at people within a particular LSM to say, these ones that end between this much and this much, these are the people that we look after. But what about the people that are on the bottom of the value chain?
In the
lower LSM. I mean, that's why right now, one of the things that I said, I think to be Dumela last week when you're talking, to say right now, we've had so much response, I think, with the feature to say, I think this year we need to really take it to the people and teach people how can they make side hustle or income, additional income. Because reality is with this high turning interest rate that is going up, everything becoming expensive, things are becoming pricey.
And it's becoming harder to have that extra bit of money to invest.
No, definitely. And companies are not going to pay you better because now everything is becoming expensive.
Exactly.
So now we're living in a
Your annual increase doesn't even match inflation.
You see what I mean? So it's something that how can we teach people how to make additional income so that they're able to build investment for themselves, so that you know that you're not dependent on somebody, but you're dependent on yourself and your investment to actually smile to the bank.
Now, the main thing, okay, and that's why Deboho's here, is to give us the advice and the right tips. So I want you to just break down for us, what are the top three best investment plans right now, according to you?
Okay.
So, just according to you and your personal opinion, what are the three best investment plans?
Okay, I'll give you a top three plus a bonus. The top three one, it's the unit trust. The unit trust and the money market, I think for me, they're top two. And they're the top two in the sense of they are very regulated. And they are objective driven. So I'll make an example. With a unit trust, it's a lot of investors or people that it doesn't matter from what income you come, we can all contribute to actually contribute into this fund, that a fund manager will actually find suitable assets that they could invest in, maybe for
on your behalf almost.
On your behalf.
Okay.
Because you might not definitely have the expertise to do that. Where else? With the money market are more short term loans, it's the lending. And the borrowing auction of the loans, because reality is we're living in a cashless society, and if people are more in demand of cash. You're building a house, people want cash and things like that. Do you understand?
You're so throwing a wedding.
Yes, from a return point of view.
Need the cash. Yeah,
and this definitely cannot go without saying tax-free account. The tax-free account, we've got a lot of products out there. But one thing that
explain the tax-free account.
Okay, the tax-free account, it's an account that is open that was launched by the government. that you can actually invest money for a certain period. You can invest up to $500,000 without it being taxed. So, and there's actually a certain bracket to say a year you can invest up to this much, and a following year you can reverse up to that much. So now for me, what I
when you say I'm not going to be taxed, am I not going to be taxed on what? The dividends? Am I not going to be taxed on...
Yes, you know, you're going to be taxed on the dividends. You're not going to be taxed out of the interest that you're making, as long as you do not cross a certain ratio.
Threshold, yeah.
You know, threshold in terms of your money. So, but for me, one thing I've realized is that ever since then, everyone else came into the market to say, you know what, this is our offering in terms of investment account. Check the tax-free account that works for you. For me, I think what I always encourage, it's the ETF, you know, tax-free accounts, because those ones have realized they've given much better interest rate return than many others. So then from there, the last and the bonus one for me, I think it's property. Yes, that's why I think for me, I mean, next week, Saturday, on Tuesday.
But you often hear, Deborah, you often hear that it's not the market or it's not the right time. Property investment's not what it used to be.
Yes.
You still think it is?
I very much think it is. You know what I've realized? There's a lot of misconstrued, you know, discussions around property. That's why for me, I mean, I've been having a lot of people sending me inboxes, tweeting me and sending emails to say, teach us how to do this. And that's why for me, next week, Saturday, I decided to say, you know what, let me have this event where I can really talk to people as to how you can make money out of property. Because right now, people, they've got this misconception that you need money to invest in property, and you don't need money to invest in property.
Wow.
Do you understand? And the kinds of property and how to find good deals. Because the idea is to buy below market, do you understand? And from there, sell at higher market or even retain. So the problem is that people, those that have done it wrong. And sometimes people hear somebody saying it on radio or wherever, and without doing research, and they quickly run into it because their salary allows them to.
What I really liked in terms of financial trends that have happened is how something as informal as stokvels have become formalized by these banking institutions.
Yes.
So now you can actually go into the bank, abo mama, abo koko, and actually have an account, and it's now been formalized.
Yes.
I just want to find out, if I want to find more information, of course, you're not always accessible. Go to my local bank. Who do I speak to in terms of these options that you've listed? My banker, my financial advisor?
For me, what I've realized, it's all well and good to go to your bank. But let's be honest, a banker, it's a business. So they'll more sell you their product and what is suitable for them than what is out there in the market.
Yeah.
So there's the Stokvel Association of South Africa, that every other Stokvel needs to be registered with them.
Okay.
So with that, you'd find that they would list the kind of Stokvels that they have, and the investment Stokvel and this and that. Then from the, what you need to do, you need to investigate those Stokvel.
For yourself. Yeah.
Because the problem with Stokvels is that they self-regulated. I could make a rule now and change it next year or in the next 5 years, and you've already put your money in. So, and that could be working as a risk for you. Where else with a bank, it's different.
It's
so
regulated.
That's why. At the end of the day, information is out there. People must look for information.
Awesome. Perfect stuff. That was your Tap on Finance this week. Deborah, thanks for coming through. And again.